Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous forecast, we estimated that the first week of March would be critical and that there could potentially be major to great seismic activity. If you look at the actual seismic activity that occurred at the time of the critical planetary geometry, we see a 6.5 on the 1st and also on the 2nd of March, followed by a magnitude 6.9 on the 4th. And that was the largest seismic event since the major earthquakes in Turkey last month. These strong earthquakes from the 1st to the 4th is the strongest clustering so far, and as you can see, it matches the critical geometry around the 2nd. Fortunately, so far, no major or great seismic event. Why? Well, as I explained so often, the great variable is the amount of stress in Earth's crust. We cannot measure that, we cannot know that. So even if we have very critical planetary geometry, as around the 2nd of March, we may only see some seismic increase or strong to major seismic activity as we had from the 1st to the 4th. A common misconception is that when a larger earthquake doesn't break the news, that nothing happened. But it is important to realize that most larger earthquakes occur in remote areas and do not have an impact on society, so they will not break the news. I see in the media and in the social media that nothing much happened in the first week of March. But if you look at the strong earthquakes in the first week, it was the strongest seismic activity in 4 weeks. So we cannot say that nothing happened, only it happened in remote areas, fortunately. Overall, we can see that the first scenario that I discussed in the previous forecast actually played out. The largest earthquakes around the 3rd, 4th, and additional stronger seismic activity around 6-7, and we see a clustering of two strong earthquakes on the 7th at full moon. So what are we going to have in the coming week? We have a higher lunar peak later tomorrow, and this is caused by a lunar conjunction with Jupiter. That's the peak that you see here, the green peak. It is followed on the 10th by a planetary conjunction. That will be the Sun, Mercury and Saturn. If you look at the solar system, we actually see the lunar peak. This is the lunar conjunction with Jupiter, marked by the green line. And we also see Sun, Mercury and Saturn in a conjunction. That will be on the 10th. The planetary conjunction on itself is not considered critical. However, the lunar conjunction with Jupiter can be somewhat critical, and we could have some stronger seismic activity as a result. The rule of thumb is we add 2 days and then give or take 1 day. That would take us to the 11th, later on the 11th, give or take 1 day, where we could potentially see some seismic increase. It could be a little bit earlier, it could be a little bit later, but the lunar conjunction with the gas giant like Jupiter, that can be a little bit more critical. How critical exactly? I'm not sure. Again, that depends on the condition of Earth's crust. If you look at the atmospheric fluctuations that we had in the last couple of days, we had some obvious fluctuations on the 4th. One was over the West Pacific, and we've seen already some stronger seismic activity in the Philippines and also the Kuril Islands. And another one marked regions over Asia, and I marked the Himalaya mountain range, but I wasn't all too sure about that. It could have been a bit to the right or to the left. This is a little bit vague. So that's a little bit of a question mark there. And then on the 6th, just 2 days ago, we had fluctuations marking Chile and also the South Sandwich Islands region and the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. These fluctuations could become significant in the next few days, especially after the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. So that will be the 11th, around the 11th of March. This is the update so far. Stay safe. Until next time.